No, but she'll be confused. She'll be saying all sorts of things.
What things? What's she going to tell you?
I don't know. I have no idea.
Hey, where have you been? The handover was ages ago.
And the five.
No, I'm late in it.
Listen, I'll call you to tell you what happened.
Joseph, I'm worried. You know, even from her hospital bed, she manages to cause trouble between us.
There's no trouble between us. You've missed your window. I just gave her a sedative. Was she talking?
She asked for you.
Do we know why she crashed? What else did she say?
I wasn't trying to decipher it. I'm more concerned as a brain injury.
How long?
We're monitoring her sodium levels and hoping for the best. If we populate our narrative, it suggests that she's been aware of her presence, that everything's functioning.
Did she mention phoning me on any, I missed five calls from her.
Like I say, it wasn't coherent. There was something about Faye, Lucas, Greenlands. All we need to know is which one of us is the Tin Man and which one's the Scarecrow.
Who's Lucas?
Isn't that Lucas?
No, that's Lucas.
Right. Anyway, something in our consciousness is piecing things together. It just takes time. Yeah. She's in respiratory arrest.
What do we think happened?
I don't know. Possibly a problem with the medication.
An overdose?
From Mazenol. I don't know. You need to ask the nurse or check with Faye.
Faye?
She was last with her.
Faye's been with me all morning.
I was talking to her here half an hour ago.
And you think she altered the dose?
Of course I don't think that. Okay, page green. Let's intubate.
No, don't. Intubate. You see, she's regaining consciousness.
Okay, fine. Forget it. Do you want to find Faye?
Find Faye, yeah. Find her.
Hey,
it's me. I thought you just walked right past you. I wondered if you'd come down for a coffee or something.
Jack?
Okay, well, when you get this, perhaps you could give me a call back. Hello, Mr. Norris.
Oh, mate, thank God you found me. I couldn't for the life of me remember where you said it was. I've been up and down the wards.
Darwin. Mr. Darwin.
There you go.
I would say it was 20, not 30.
Oh, yeah, right, sorry. I'm all over the shop. Because of my kid, you know. Oh, yes, of course.
Extended lifespans, a real possibility. Perhaps electronic implants in the organs will email messages to a computer offering a readout with a diagnosis. Imagine the chance to read what is happening inside a broken body. Take what I have here in the palm of my hand. You'd have to look quite hard. It's invisible to the naked eye. But what I could have here is a nanobot. Tiny robot that once injected into the bloodstream could find its way to the damaged organ and do my job in ways that I can't possibly imagine.
She's married, Joseph.
to a man named Lucas. Don't believe me, but believe them. Bring them.
No need for anesthetic. And now.
I thought I was doing the right thing.
Oh, really? Would that be the stalking or the snooping?
Joseph, I didn't come out of it all that well. You might have noticed.
You were overtaking on a blind bend.
Was I?
You know you were.
No? Well, sort of. My memory keeps phasing in and out. I remember bits. Can't actually see it when I think back, just being on the bike and then flying.
She remembers some things well enough. You remembered to tell me that Faye was married.
I know. Not a nice thing to hear. Not a particularly nice thing to have to say, but like I said, I thought it was for the best.
You mean you were doing it for me?
Yes.
Because we're so close.
We were close, once.
Please don't remind me.
Joseph, I mean it. I was thinking of you. I didn't want you to be taken in, and I was right. She and Lucas...
No, you got it wrong, Jack. Like you managed to get so many things wrong. Faye isn't married. She's divorced.
Oh?
It's nobody's business but Faye's. Faye's and mine.
And you found her in South Africa?
That's right.
She's okay?
She's fine. Thank you for asking.
I'm glad. Glad it didn't turn out to be some dark secret.
Are you?
You really do have a very low opinion of me, don't you? Okay, I suppose I deserve it. Or at least, I have in the past.
But not this time, is that what you're saying?
Yes, it's exactly what I'm saying. But I can understand why you might not believe me.
Good luck with finance.
Hello, Mr. Pitt. Hello?
5-star treatment. First Joseph, now you.
Well, you could expect to be seeing a lot of us. Necessary observation. You came a cropper.
Is that the exact medical term?
No, the exact medical term is a hell of a cropper. How are your ribs?
Broken, painful, but okay.
BP's a tad wobbly. That's another piece of medical jargon. Have you never thought about buying yourself a nice little runaround?
Should see the bike I almost bought.
Could you sit up for me? Right. Thank you.
Sounds like Joseph had a good time in South Africa.
Did he? Good.
Yeah, he found Faye.
Good.
Seems as if things are okay between them.
You know, Jack, it's none of my business, and it's not really any of your business either.
Well, in a way.
Is it? Why?
Past.
I would have thought it was the past that disqualified you.
Well, that depends which way you look at it.
Some people would say there's only one way to look at it.
And are you one of them, Elliot? Do you think I only ever act out of self-interest and spite?
No. No, of course not.
Good. Now all I'll have to do is convince the rest of the world.
Any shortness of breath?
Not really. You're wondering if the broken rib has found its way into my lung and the x-rays don't help.
That's about it, yes. Do you know what the chances are of surviving a bike crash travelling at that speed?
Please don't tell me I was lucky.
No. You are flipping lucky.
How are you doing?
You tell me. I was having a dream.
Pleasant?
No, it was about the crash. If I hadn't followed Faye, if I hadn't been checking on her, then you'd never have known about Lucas and Greenland's. I'm not saying that excuses it. In fact, I feel... It just made me think.
Good result from a bad act?
Sort of, yeah.
What were you going to say? You said, I feel...
Ashamed. I feel ashamed. Mostly about what I did to you.
Well, that's past.
But not forgotten. Not by either of us. And it might not help much, but... I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. It was a mistake. No, it was wrong. Following Faye, trying to catch her out. Wanting to, I suppose. I'm going to talk to her when she gets back. Apologize. I mean it. I'm sorry. Not just for harassing Faye, that was... I thought you were being played for a fool. I'm apologizing for everything. Everything that went wrong between us.
Everything? Well, that would take a pretty sizable apology.
Yes, I know. Joseph, I nearly died, and since then I've had plenty of time to lie here and think about myself. About myself as a grade-A bitch.
That would be grade-A scheming, bitch.
You're thinking pneumothorax, aren't you?
Yes. Well, air entry is normal. There's no real evidence. We'll just have to keep an eye on you. We're coming back from time to time.
So Lyndon went with you to South Africa?
Lyndon came, yeah.
How did you track her down?
Does it matter?
Not really. Why did she go there?
Well, that's Faye's business.
Do you know?
You still don't trust her, do you? Do you think I shouldn't trust her? You still think that I'm being, what was it you said? Played for a fool?
No, Joseph, I don't think
that. Yes, but you're wrong. That's not the way it is between Faye and me, which is why we got engaged. In South Africa. Don't say anything.
Not even congratulations?
No, I mean, don't say anything to anyone else. No one knows. I shouldn't have told you.
Don't worry. Your secret's safe with me.
Laparoscopic stack.